going to be a little demonstration of interactions and transfers between one kind of mechanical energy and another. One kind of mechanical energy is kinetic energy. Kinetic energy is an energy of motion. It depends on the speed. Down here, this equation shows you the kinetic energy depends on the square of the speed. V is the speed. And it depends on the mass of whatever the object is. The object, by the way, is going to be this skateboarder right here. And I'm going to build a track for the skateboarder out of this thing. And we will see not too weird a track. We'll see how it works. The other kind of mechanical energy is an interaction energy. Potential energy is a generic name for interaction energies. Gravitational potential energy is an interaction between this mass M, that would be the skateboarder has the mass M, and G represents the other part of the interaction, the interactions between the skateboarder and the Earth. G is the gravitational field of the Earth. H is a measure of the distance between the skateboarder and the Earth. And so if the skateboarder is higher up, then the gravitational potential energy is higher. The skateboarder is farther down, then it's lower. Over here on the right, you can see a bar graph of the various energies, kinetic, potential, thermal, and total. And if I put the skateboarder up here at the top, I see that the potential energy has gotten larger. And of course, the total energy is made up of all of these, so that has also gotten larger, and in fact is equal to the potential. The kinetic energy is zero because the skateboarder is not moving, so the speed is zero. You can see up here there's a speed chart, or a speed dial, so the speed is shown. And when I start this simulation, what the skateboarder is going to do what you expect, which is go farther and farther down. As the height goes down, the potential energy will go down. But since energy is conserved, another energy is going to have to go up. And I've got friction turned off here. So the skateboarder is going to be going down a friction-free path on friction-free wheels and is not going to be losing any energy to thermal energy. And so we can watch what happens when I hit the go button. Skateboarder goes down, goes faster and faster and faster. As the skateboarder goes down, the potential energy went down and the kinetic energy went up. Let me return it and we'll see it again. Look over here on the right. As the skateboarder drops down, the potential goes down and the kinetic goes up. Maximum speed is about 5. Let me stop this thing again. The maximum speed is about 5. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. And the maximum speed just depends on the initial height. For instance, you start in a different return the skater. Let me start in a different spot, same height, but have a different track. So now instead of slowly speeding up, the skateboarder is going to speed up kind of fast and then speed up more slowly later on. But the same result. Still end up at 5. Kinetic energy is the total energy and gravitational potential energy has gone down to 0. I can look at it a different way. Return the skater again, make sure he's on this thing. At the same initial height. Not sure it's exactly the same height, but pretty close. It's not measuring the speed right now, so that's with the earlier speed when I stopped it. But when I start it again, the speed will go back to being measured, so it'll start down here. And then as the gravitational potential energy goes down. If you look on the right, the kinetic energy will be going up an equal amount. And in the end, speed is 5. Let me stop this. Return the skater. Turn on some friction. Why not? What happens if there's friction? Well, energy will go into thermal energy. It goes into thermal energy, then as the gravitational potential energy goes down, both kinetic and thermal will go up. You can see what's going to happen. The sum has to be the total, so the kinetic just can't go up as much. if there's thermal energy. And you can't see what's going on, but because there's friction, the thermal energy is going up still, and the skater way off the screen is slowing down to a halt. So the skater's off, stopped there somewhere. You could probably stop the skater in our view if I do it right. So let me stop this, return the skater to where they started, turn the friction on a lot. That didn't work. Put this skater there, start it. You can see the skater was slowing down, but slower and slower and slower. Skater goes slower. Thermal energy goes up. Eventually, it's all thermal energy. One of the things you find out is that friction forces, any kind of resistance, turns mechanical energy into thermal energy. What if we go in the other direction? Well, direction doesn't matter. Let me stop this. Return the skater. Where is our skater? Put him back where it belongs. Start him in the other direction. Goes to the right. But started at the same height. Again, all mechanical energy turns into thermal energy.